The Home Assistant operating system allows you to store most of its data on an external fast storage, such as SSD drive or USB flash drive. That means, for example, with a Raspberry Pi, the boot and main operating system partitions can stay on a SD card as usual. But the Home Assistant Core, Supervisor, Locks and Add-ons can go on a fast SSD storage. This hybrid scenario is fully supported by Home Assistant, and some say it is even more reliable than booting the Home Assistant from USB entirely. Of course, it can be much faster than staying with SD card only. In other words, you're getting the best of both worlds, and everything is official and supported. On top, you can convert your already running Home Assistant installation without losing any data. The procedure that I'm about to show you is very easy and will move your existing data to an external data disk automatically. Let's begin. The things that you will need are the following: a device like this Raspberry Pi 4, running Home Assistant OS installed on a SD card, which is the most typical scenario. Other devices that are booting from SD card can also be used as long as they are supported by Home Assistant. You also need a fast USB SSD drive that is bigger in size than the SD card, not physically, but in terms of gigabytes. I'm using this ADATA SSD drive, which is working perfectly. You can check the current price of it in Amazon from the links in the video description. Have in mind that the data inside this disk will be overwritten and the whole disk will be erased. If you have something valuable inside, backup it first. Same is valid for the Home Assistant. It is highly recommended to create a full backup and to actually download this backup somewhere safe before you continue further. When you are ready with the backups, boot your Home Assistant OS from the SD card as usual. Connect the SSD drive to any of the blue USB ports on your device as they are faster. Open your Home Assistant web interface and go to Configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor, System tab, and click on this three dots menu and select Move Data Disk. You are currently using DevMMC something as Datadisk. This is my SD card. Moving Datadisk will reboot your device and it is estimated to take 10 minutes. Your Home Assistant installation will not be accessible during this period. Do not disconnect the power during the move. Okay, I'm ready to select my SSD drive. Here it is, and I'll just have to click Move. Look how easy the whole process is. The complexity of this procedure is hidden under the hood, so you can enjoy your time freely and do something more meaningful and useful, like hitting the like button. The system will prepare the Home Assistant external data disk and will reboot. The whole procedure will take 10, 15 or even more minutes. The speed of your new data disk will affect that time, but in any case, please be patient and do not shut down or reboot the device until it is all finished. Alternatively, you can use the command line interface to create your Home Assistant external data disk. This is only needed if for some reason you don't want to use the UI method that we just saw. To access the command line interface, you either have to attach a monitor and a keyboard to your device, or you can install terminal and SSH add-on. Again, use this command line interface method only if the previous graphical method is not working for you or you don't like it for some reason. So, go to your Home Assistant username and make sure that advanced mode is enabled, like that. Then go to configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor, Add-on Store, and install this add-on, Terminal and SSH. When the installation is completed, click on the Start button. and then on the Open Web UI. Type here HAOS info. From this line here you can see that the Datadisk is dev MMC block something. That means currently our Datadisk is located on the SD card. Connect your USB drive and type HAOS Datadisk list. This is the USB drive that I want to use as Datadisk, external Datadisk for Home Assistant. So the next command and the final command that I have to type is HAOS Datadisk move dev SDA. Like that. And then I'll have to hit enter. That's it. The same procedure will follow. Restart with 10 to 15 to 20 minutes of moving the Datadisk from the SD card to the USB drive. If you have issues with the USB attached SSD drive, one possible reason can be not enough power for the device and the SSD drive. The quick fix for that is to use a powered USB hub. You have to connect the powered hub to your device and plug the SSD drive in the powered hub. That way, the power supply of the hub will power the SSD drive just nicely. Alternatively, you can omit the hub and try with more powerful power supply, if you happen to have one. Don't forget to subscribe for my channel with the notification bell if you haven't done that already. That way, you'll be notified when I release a new video. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!